conference everybody on a Sunday morning is, I think, a little tired. So what I try to do is to give a little different perspective. You heard the consumer's voice. Let me talk of the infrastructure sector and competition in the infrastructure sector as a whole. Electricity is, of course, part of it. The point is that infrastructure sector involves a lot of dilemmas for policymakers. You know them, you've heard about them, growth versus environment and sustainability, state versus market, economics versus politics. There are a lot of technical issues involved, I mean, whether it's a financing issues, technology issues, project implementation issues. So it's a very complex sector. We have, I think, this country, everybody recognizes the importance of infrastructure. Government has made a lot of efforts, but we don't seem to be getting where we want to. So I would like to very briefly say what is possible way forward, how we can supplement and strengthen whatever is being done. And I think the three elements of today's topic, transparency, competition, and consumer interest, let me say, instead of choice at the moment, I think that is something which can take you in the direction. And what I would recommend for your consideration is a three-pronged strategy which builds on these three elements. So now what are these three elements of this three-pronged strategy? I think the first is we must take up necessary governance reforms. It is extremely important also to build the institutional infrastructure before you get the physical infrastructure. I think this is a point we all recognize, but we don't state it that clearly. I mean, it is the institutions which deliver. It is leadership is important, other things are important, but it's the institutional structure as a whole. It is the, how you build the institution. What are the institutions, how they operate? And that is while a larger part of governance reform. I think institutional reforms has to be recognized as important by itself. What is the regulatory institution that you have? What kind of financing institutions you have? What kind of system for conflict resolution you have? A lot of issues. I think that is a key issue. And I think whether electricity, and I've heard, I mean, Mr. Dev is my batchmate, and we have a number of friends who are in this sector in the regulatory capacities. I hear all the time, and I see that the sector, and this is, I think, what Mr. Dahl said, we don't seem to be getting there, and a lot of other things are coming. There's again an institution. He mentioned to the judicial intervention. That's also an institution. So I think this is important. The second, and this is my field as member competition commission, we must make markets work. I'll explain all these. And the third one, let me say that we must convert stakeholders into shareholders. You know, we keep on talking about stakeholders. Can we make them shareholders? Now, I'll explain this a little later. But let me take these one by one. I think on governance reforms, you heard so much yesterday what Mr. Salman Khurshid said, what Mr. Taneja said, what Mr. Suresh Prabhu said. I mean, if you're not there, one or two things I will mention because Justice Verma wasn't there. Mr. Taneja says, we require a new energy order and a center state energy council. It's that kind of thing. Mr. Salman Khurshid says, we have not looked at administrative reforms. This should be a priority. Mr. Suresh Prabhu says, we need transparent, consistent, sustainable, bipartisan policies and effective decision-making processes. And then he goes on to suggest a role for parliamentary standing committees. So I think yesterday's four-room discussion made it clear that governance reforms is a must. And in the absence of the governance reforms, the political will, as I said, 90% it's politics. So the political will and leadership would not happen. But today, I do believe that we are moving in a direction where it should be possible. So let me just, I'm a civil servant, 42 years experience. So there's a couple of things which have come from my experience. I think in governance, mindset is the key issue. What is the mindset of the policymaker? What is the mindset of those who are exercising authority? This is the key issue. Institutional arrangements must be in place to meet key requirements of financing, technology, project execution capabilities, etc. Then clarity and long-term certainty in policy and terms of engagement. I think this is what you're referring to just now. Can you change the rules of the game midway? People come with a lot of, and how do you get the investor confidence? You will not get it unless there's clarity and ambiguity. I mean, in the absence of that, it's not going to happen. you must be clear in your mind, you must communicate it clearly, and there must be terms which are clearly established not to be changed. And I mean, that is something, an institutional issue as to how you come together, and I'll comment on that a little later. I mean, even the systems, yes.
Yeah, a very important point you just raised, and I just thought I'll intervene because
please,
some of the people have joined the conference later and all. Going back to what Mr. Suresh Prabhu said yesterday, he came up with an idea that if you pass a regulatory, an investment in policy for infrastructure and codify the rules of engagement in Parliament, then no CBI, CVC and all this nonsense can happen. But somebody later on pointed out, I think it was the chairman of the Orissa Regulatory Commission, if you do that, if you want to fine-tune it, you have to go back to Parliament, which is very cumbersome.
Yes, yes.
So what's the solution here? What is the middle path?
Well, let me put it this way. I have been a witness to a number of standing committees. I spent 20 years in Government of India in Under-Secretary, Joint Secretary, Secretary, Additional Secretary and all that. I would say this standing committee system is extremely strong. Now, what we do, I mean, as Secretary of Corporate Affairs, I have got half a dozen acts passed. So I understood the legal process. See, what you want to do, things which you don't need to really change, the fundamentals you keep in the act. Things which, you know, you think you need to change, you say, as may be prescribed. Now, the as may be prescribed is where you bring the rules from the government. Now, the government rules are the executive thing, which can be changed with the approval of the minister.
Which is exactly the problem recently, where the rules of the government at that time are being questioned by the CAG in certain contexts, and aspirations are perhaps being cast on various people, whoever they are. So how do you sort that issue out?
Yeah. Now again, obviously the answers here will be conceptual, and as I said, it is the mindset of the person who's operating the system which is going to make the difference. But the answer is very clear, that if, sorry, I missed the thread on this one. Can you just repeat the last part?
You see, if you are going to give discretion,
how do you change it? Yes.
How do you change? Then somebody can come 10 years later and say, 10 years ago there was something wrong you did.
There are two parts of it. One is, to the extent it is possible, and we must realize the limitations, to the extent it's possible, make it part of the contract, the concession agreement and all that. The second is the part of institution building. Again, I'll again and again come to institution. You see, institutions and people who operate it are at the heart of the whole issue. Whether it's political institutions, whether it's administrative institutions, government institutions.
I'm with you on that. Where I want this audience to get a reaction from you as a part of the Competition Commission, because you are a very important forum for us, because electricity is a natural monopoly. Let's take the concession, I won't name the place, of a road toll-based road. 25-year concession, 3 years down the line after it has been constructed, some politician, I mean, my friend Patikrit in the previous session talked about third-party non-state actor. A non-state actor, political activist comes, burns down those toll booths, saying there is a corrupt minister involved, whoever he is, God knows who he is. Nothing has happened in terms of a judicial process, and stops them from collecting the toll. And there's an agitation all across that particular state that not to pay the toll. Cascading impact of that goes into Delhi,
yes, yes,
on the Delhi-Gurgaon situation, where a 25-year concession, someone has decided 25 years is too long. Someone who is not involved in the contract, neither is he government, nor is he private, nor is he the contracting party.
True.
Right? So
true.
This is one aspect of our beautiful democracy. I'm talking about from the investor's confidence point of view. How do you deal with this? Is a very, very important question for this country's future, if we want to build infrastructure and if we want to get money in.
As Competition Commission has no role in this, so I mean, what I'm answering is more on my other experience. I would say,
I can suggest something. May I suggest something?
Please.
You know, in the context of what Harry was saying earlier about somebody questioning something that you decided by the use of your discretion. 10 years down the line, somebody says, "How did you do this?" One possible solution to this kind of a problem is the good old practice of recording what are called speaking orders, where you write down why you took a particular decision in so much detail that it becomes very difficult for anybody later on to question.
That is true, of course. That is what we're saying, that there is there, to the extent that you can, you know, everything can never be put on paper and there'll always circumstances. And we all know this, how this these things operate. So certainly, that certainly we should do that. The concession agreement should be, and I'm sure the concession agreement must have been good. The issues, circumstances arise and decisions are forced practically. Now that is, I don't think there's a legal solution. Personally, I have a view which has not happened, but which will also combine all the people here and people there. I strongly believe, and to that extent, though I'm new to this EPI as a body, EPI as a body, but I appreciated when I saw what they do. I think the answer, and I'll not jump the gun and go to the third issue I was saying, converting stakeholders into shareholders, what is it? Every complex thing, and how infrastructure is very complex. I mean, it's a huge project, doing people involved, organizations involved, institutions involved, amounts involved, complexity, technology, finance, very complex. It involves any number of institutions and people and local leadership and all sorts of things. How do you work together? There's only one way. You must consciously design an institutional system for them to work together. You must create a platform in which they work together. It's not going to work otherwise. And in that platform, the consumer must be an important thing. Now let's take infrastructure, whether it's electricity or anything else. You see how the projects are designed? At that time, the consumer or the local community doesn't know what's happening. I mean, in the project design, and I have had detailed discussions with all sorts of people. They have no idea what's going to hit them. When it comes to there on the ground, they say, what is this? And then you have these dharnas. And then people out there say, well, you know, these are bad people. They are creating problems. I mean, what are you talking of? I mean, consumer voice is not, sorry. I mean, I'm very good friends with Pradeep Mehta. And consumer voice is not about consumer protection. I think consumer voice should be about partnering with industry, partnering with the regulator, partnering with government, partnering with political parties and whatever. You partner together all those who are concerned. After all, who is not concerned about the development of this country? Who is not concerned about the infrastructure in this country? Who is not concerned about the electricity in this country? I think that is something to be done. Now, who will take the leadership? I don't know. What this association is doing is a good job. So that is the kind of thing. And why I'm calling them shareholders? Shareholders hold you accountable. So if you're part of the system, after all, in this country, you have had examples in the last 2 years where different levels of government have been held accountable through consumers, people, or whatever. I think that is something which, Mr. Thal, you know it much better than me, and Pramod Dev told me his long association and what all you have done. I don't think there are any easy answers, but I think we must act in a mode of partnership with a will to do, and I think that will exist today. That is why I'm optimistic. Now I'll just close because I think I've run out of the time. I'll just make one point. This is on making markets work. I think there's a lot of innovation required there, a lot of thinking required there, because last 8 years I have been into this competition regulation, and last 5 years in Competition Commission. Frankly, at 37 years in IAS, I never realized the power of market to the extent I do now. Market can do wonders for efficiency and accountability, both. Now, can you make markets work? I'm now currently working on a concept where can you have all delivery systems by creating the kind of markets instead of government delivery? Can you do that? In your road infrastructure, you have, of course, 4 or 5 people who can take it. Can you create a next level of subcontractors and a market there where there's much more competition? So I think there are a lot of issues there as to how to open up existing areas, even in infrastructure. See, in infrastructure, major issue, it's a natural monopoly. What do? Obviously, you must give the initial contract based on a very fair competition. That goes without saying. Have a very good PPP arrangement. And the PPP should be seen not only as a means of getting private investment, but also, as was mentioned yesterday, as a method of sharing risk. I think PPP was discussed in detail. But there's a second aspect of this. What about distribution networks, transmission? Now, this is where we, and this is very important to electricity. I think this is where we have a role. Competition Commission has a role. Because there's a doctrine called the doctrine of essential facility, where we can formally enforce this thing, that you must share that monopoly facility subject to fair, reasonable, and non-discriminatory terms with your competitors. So there's competition with cooperation. And what people have done in Europe and Australia on railroad, they have said the rail itself is an essential facility, and this will be available to everybody. And now you compete above the rail market and below the rail market. So I mean, I'll conclude here by saying that in infrastructure, problems will be solved through partnerships, through empowering not only the consumer, but all of us together on a single platform, and through innovative use of market in new ways. Thank you.